I filmed a dead makeup look because I know that I want to be something dead for Halloween. I just didn't know what, and I didn't want to make it too complicated. You can use this with any type of look you want. You don't have to be wearing makeup to do this. It's really easy. All I used was eyeshadow and some fake blood. You don't have to use the fake blood. You could maybe mix some Vaseline with red eyeshadow or lipstick, really anything you want. Just be creative with it. There's no real steps to doing this. I just showed you my version of doing it. I just used the Naked Basics palette for this, and I layered the browns under my eye to make myself look more tired, more dirty. I didn't really know exactly what I was doing. I just know that, or I knew that I wanted to make myself look dead. The key to this is to blend, because you don't want just black and brown lines all over your face. Yeah, just take the time to blend under your eyes just to make yourself look more tired. And that's when my eyes started bugging me because I got eyeshadow in my eyes. And after that, I use the same red lip liner that I used on my lips under my eyes. You don't have to do this part, I just wanted to make myself look sick. And I blended it out with my fingers. And this is really just a really simple version of something scary you can do on Halloween. I'm going to be doing more of these, but you know, if you don't have all the Halloween makeup, or if you don't want to go spend it just for one day, you can just use the makeup you already have, or you can buy something that you're going to use in the future. All you really need is some brown and black eyeshadow. And I just kept blending just to make myself look more and more dirty. Then I applied the darkest brown onto my temples and my forehead, not really contouring, more for that grave looking effect. Like maybe I just got out of the grave or something. And I do know that I want to be something like vintage looking for Halloween, but I also wanted to be dead, so I thought this was a good way of doing it. Once I did that, I just applied some Duo Clear glue onto my hand, and then I patted it right next to my lips. You don't have to do it there, I just wanted to because I didn't know where else to put it. And I applied two layers of this, I think. And you just want that to dry completely so then you can start picking it apart. And while that dried, I just applied a warm brown. I applied Sienna under all the other browns I applied just to make it look more dirty. And like I said, there's no right way of doing this. It's just however you feel comfortable or how dead you want to look. And then I started just rubbing against that glue I applied to make it look more blotchy. And once you apply the eyeshadow onto it, it's gonna look like a real cut or wound or whatever you want it to look like. And once again, I just layered some browns all over it, and you could really see the lines like just all broken and gross there. You don't have to cut it open with like some scissors or a toothpick or anything, you just need to rub on it. And you could use regular glue for this too. And I believe this is where I applied some red lipstick, I think. Yeah. That's where I applied some red lipstick just to give it a more fresh wound look. And I applied fake blood onto it to make it look fresh and gross. Like I said, you don't need fake blood. I just wanted to give the look a little something extra. And just apply that really anywhere you want. I wanted to apply it under my eyes, but I got scared of it actually getting into my eyes, so I applied it sort of there, mostly on my cheek. And you can stop right there if you want, but I decided to go a little further. I decided to give myself a black eye, and all I did was apply black all over my eyelid. And it looked too perfect, I guess, so I decided to blend it out. I just really like this technique because you could do it with anything you want and just make any makeup look or Halloween look a little scary, I guess. Oh, and this part is really bad because I didn't realize putting glue on my eyelid would just hurt after, so I probably should have just applied it to my eyebrow. But what I like is the effect it gives after. So once it dried, I just kind of rubbed it and my eyebrow looked really gross, so I really did like that. I shouldn't have taken it further down to my eyelid. And once again, I just started applying a bunch of browns onto it again. And then I applied a little more blood onto it. And like I said, you could do as much or as little you want with this look. This was just my version of it. And I hope you liked it. And I will be coming out with more Halloween looks. And please subscribe. And thank you for watching.